Hi, you are watching VSDC channel. In this tutorial, we'll show you how to add a stylish character introduction to your video. So, if you're working on a video with several characters, it's a great practice to introduce them to the viewers, one by one, in a unique way. And you'll be surprised how easy it is to implement. Here's what happens. The video freezes, then a custom introduction frame appears, and then you just add some text intro. Without further ado, let's see how it's done. Create a new project and import your footage. Find a good moment in the video you'd like to use for the introduction. Right here. Now make a cut and a snapshot. Pull your snapshot from the resources window, then set the snapshot duration at 3 seconds. Create some space between the two pieces of video and place it directly in that gap. Duplicate the snapshot and place the two copies one under another on the timeline. Make a double click on the one on the top and select the Free Shape tool from the left-hand side menu. This is an advanced character intro tutorial, so we are going to use the Free Shape tool to separate the character from the background. Once ready, paint the shape black and open the Blending Modes menu. Select Inverted Mask. Now, if you go back to the Main Timeline tab and switch between the Show and Hide Object settings, you'll see the results right away. But let's go back and apply the zoom effect to the object. Our goal is to make it appear closer and closer without exposing its copy in the background. To achieve that, you'll need to activate the cross, which will be the point of growth, and you need to place it in the right spot to hide the duplicate. Switch to Dynamic Level Change and set 100-115, which will be the point of growth, and you need to place it in the right spot to hide the duplicate. Double-click on the bottom snapshot copy. It's time to choose the background. Suppose you want it to be animated. Although, even if you have no plan, you can easily improvise. For instance, add a rectangle and paint it any color you want. Next, place a few elements to the scene using Free Shape templates. You'll find them if you select the option From Gallery. To animate them, apply the rotation effect. And change the rotation angle to 0.30 or 0.15. Apply the grayscale filter to the character figure and to top it off, add a glitch effect to the background. This looks great! And now you know how to create your own character introduction. If this tutorial was helpful, give it the thumbs up and subscribe. The next video is coming very soon.